próxima corrida será no Circuit de Prague, uma pista com longas curvas e chicanes estreitas. Muito bem, você completou o volume Ícones Esportivos na História do Automobilismo. Agora, vamos ver como se sai no Gran Turismo, os carros de rua mais rápidos do mundo.
These are the poster cars. The ones you had on your bedroom wall as a kid. Who knows, you might still have them on your wall. Because even if you're old enough to buy proper art in frames, it'll never look as good as the cars we have here. They're the ones we all dream of. The ones built in exotic places with top speeds and acceleration times that can literally take your breath away. Many of these cars are built with space-grade materials and push road car physics to the limits using race-derived technology. But even if you become immensely rich, you might still need to know the right people in the right places to be allowed to buy one. Others suit a more down-to-earth budget, but they all have a huge amount of power, and many will go way beyond 200 miles per hour.
Algumas das primeiras corridas de automóvel cruzavam campos, florestas e montanhas. Os circuitos nesta série começam com estradas e trilhas de terra até chegar às emocionantes pistas ultramodernas construídas para a corrida.
Meet the supercar killers. The cars that can hold their own against the world's most exotic machinery without sending your bank manager into cardiac arrest. With astonishing acceleration and enough grip to peel tarmac, they offer serious bang for your buck. And you might even see one in the real world, not just in music videos.
Cada Ferrari é fabricado com cuidado, mas existe uma classe que se destaca do restante. Os supercarros topo de linha da Ferrari são apenas para a elite. Você precisa ser convidado pela Ferrari para ter a chance de comprar um. A linhagem dos supercarros modernos da Ferrari começa com o 288 GTO, um poderoso carro do Grupo B, construído antes do banimento da classificação. Um Ferrari de rua é rapidíssimo e fez tanto sucesso que o Ferrari F40 continuou a tradição de carros de corrida que se pode usar legalmente nas ruas. Essas máquinas usam a nata das tecnologias automotivas de todas as eras, como fibra de carbono, freios de cerâmica, transmissão por borboleta e até mesmo conceitos banidos em corridas como aerodinâmica ativa. O LaFerrari tem um sistema de recuperação da energia cinética parecido com o dos modernos carros de corrida híbridos, elevando os limites da tecnologia e velocidade automotiva.
If modern hypercars warped the rules of physics with space-grade technology, then early supercars did it with brute force. There were no fluffy bits in sight, no ABS, no traction control, and nowhere to hide when things got a bit crashy, which they often did. Fueled by the 80s banking boom and power-crazed brokers, these machines were raw, exhilarating, and astonishingly fast, even by today's standards. They operate on the bleeding edge of physical possibility. Some are made in batches so small and at such dizzying expense that you have to be invited to buy one. Many combine batteries with petrol to make more power and use materials you'd usually find on a spaceship. All of which has led to a new ground-based space race and unfathomable top speeds. These aren't just the fastest cars of their time. They're the fastest cars ever.